Number 1. Seed placement. Seed placement might be useless in your eyes, but I'm telling you that it definitely helps out. My current setup that always gets my customers rotating and being optimized has 40 tables, with each table having 4 seeds. This goes for floor 2 till floor 8. It doesn't overwork my waiters too much, and the rotation with spawn rate keeps it up. I show you guys a little preview of what I have right now, actually. As you can see, I got ticket tables, because ticket tables don't take a lot of space, and you can easily put 4 seats around it without it crowding your cute little area restaurant. So, as you can see, my customers are fully rotating. I just joined the game, so it's not entirely full, but it will fill up over time, and then you can keep going and going and going and going. So this is my little preview. I love it the way I have right now, and I have this from floor 2 till 8, which you kind of can see if you see this. And I really love this kind of view, because it just has little bamboo plants and sakura plants everywhere. So feel free to copy this setup if you feel like. And let's go to tip number 2. Tip number 2. Ordering stands. I am currently using 14 ordering stands to make sure all the orders get cooked and served within a few seconds. This tip is for beginners as well as for pros. Always, and I mean always, keep your order stands close to your teleporters. Don't let your waiters waste way too much time walking around to get those orders to the customers. You don't want them to go to the first floor and be like walking all around to the corner to not be able to serve their precious customers, do you? No, but keep them close to the teleporter. It will be way more efficient. As you can see, my waiters are running and running and running. They are really keeping it all up. So be sure to do that, and you will optimize your orders and your customers, of course, because it keeps them rotating. So that's tip number 2. Let's go to tip number 3. Number 3. The kitchen. A lot of people got stove, dishwashers, and order stands on each floor. This is actually not a good way to go. Having your kitchen downstairs gives more space for seats, but also has a good efficiency for your waiters. Your waiters are forced to go to the first floor and quickly intend to welcome new customers. This makes sure that your customers don't leave and quickly seats your VIP customers as well. Put the kitchen downstairs and you're optimizing your restaurant. Let's go to tip number 4. Number 4. Be AFK the right way. AFKing is something we all need in our lives, because we cannot be on our PC 24/7, right? First of all, I want to mention that you're only allowed to AFK with an auto-clicker. Using a macro is strictly forbidden, so I do not recommend that. You will get banned, believe me. Now, let's tell you how you can optimize your AFK and make it efficient for yourself. As you can see, your customers change the EUI on the different places, which makes it impossible to click. Sometimes it's on the right, sometimes it's left, sometimes it's even here or here. It kind of depends on what the customers want. But do not worry, it is possible. If you just go sidewards, you can align your auto-clicker with your customers and keep clicking, hear me clicking the button, every time they join in. So this way, your customers get directly seated and every VIP gets directly inside, and you don't have to worry anymore that you won't get your VIPs or your ghost boys. Your ghost boys, you don't want to lose those, do you? Okay, let's go to tip number 5. Number 5. Max out your floors. A lot of people are wondering why you are not getting your restaurant filled when you only got like 2 or maybe 3 floors. Let me explain you why. Customers got a spawning rate and intend to spawn within a certain amount of seconds. The floors you can buy makes it that you quicker spawn your customers. So if you want that money and fill customers, be sure to max out all 8 floors, guys. All 8 of them. Be sure to max them out. Get them customers floating every few seconds, or maybe even under a second sometime. And let's go to tip number 6. Number 6. Beginner setup. A small beginner tip for my restaurant is that you don't need expensive stuff. Get the cheapest chairs and ticket tables. Get yourself a better stove and a better dishwasher, and you're good to go for your first floor. Believe me, you're good to go. You don't need those aesthetic good looking restaurants in the beginning. It's all about getting the money, and getting yourself higher up before you get all those fancy looking stuff. Believe me, you're good to go, mate. So be sure to apply the first tip I did with it, and you will still get optimization. Just get like 13 tables or lesser if you only got one floor, because you need those kitchen standards. And you can worry about your aesthetic, beautiful, good looking restaurant later. First, let's get money and let's get efficiency going. Number 7, VIP tables. Get yourself the Royal Tables at Yes. Royal Tables give you a 10% chance on VIP customers, and Royal Chess gives you a 25% chance on VIP customers. Combine them together and it's 100%. Make sure to get these before the shrine. They will be useful on long term, so definitely do that. A lot of people are going for the shrine, but I'm telling you, don't. First go for the VIP bundle. Don't forget to get 4 chairs around the table. Using 4 chairs and 1 VIP table is almost the same amount as getting 1 shrine. So definitely do that, because for a long term it's way better. And you just want those VIP customers, don't you? Get that extra money going. Yeah. Okay, let's get to tip number 8. Number 8. Shrine. Last tip, but definitely not least. Get yourself a shrine. Shrines you can active every 15 hours to spawn a special question mark customer that you can see on the top right now. This customer can give you a lot of money, like 50k from what I remember. But it definitely boosts your money, people. So get it when you can, after the VIP tables, guys. After the VIP tables, think about the long game. Gotta think about that. Get on that leaderboard all together. And just be efficient. Well, guys, thank you very much for watching my video. And if you liked it, be sure to hit the like button and become a galleys by clicking that subscribe button. I will see you guys all later. Cheers. And bye-bye.